I just want to start by apologizing in advance. I'm losing my voice. I've been teaching high school boys how to tackle the past week, and needless to say, they've needed a lot of correction. When I heard I was inducted in the Queen's Football Hall of Fame, I realized I had to make a speech. Immediately, I thought of my coach from the Toronto Argos, Pinball Clements, who's by far the best speaker I've ever seen. While with the Argos, Pinball had a little chant. He would make a say. He would start, "Who are we?" And we would reply, "Family." And I reflected on that, thought about it. And my mind quickly drifted to my time at Queens, because I truly believe at Queens we are family. The connection between family and Queens, obviously there's some very obvious ones. It runs very deep for me. The first and most important is that I met my beautiful wife while I was in third year here at Queens. She's the most amazing mother to our three boys, Jackson, Marcus, and Isaac. And I'm truly blessed to be with her. Thanks, Bonzi, for all your love and support. To my parents, Queens football is a big part of our family. During my 5 years at Queens, they only missed actually one game. That game was in Windsor, and it was a very good game to miss. What I didn't understand is they claimed the drive to Windsor was too far. But what I couldn't figure out is that they happily came to watch our game in Laval. I think the driving distances to the two places are the same, so I couldn't quite figure out what the difference was between historic Quebec City and Windsor. But Mom and Dad, thank you so much for your never-ending love and support. There are many stories that involve family and Queens for me. My in-laws are here tonight, and I'm always grateful for their support. A little backstory, my father-in-law is writing a book which describes his escape from Czechoslovakia when the Russians invaded in 1968. Truly an amazing story for a guy who grew up in Amherst, Ontario. I tell you that because I want to tell you a little story about the first time my mother-in-law came to a football game. It was a great one to come to. I actually scored the winning touchdown against Western. And we all went out to dinner after, celebrating. My parents were there, my future wife, my future mother-in-law. I think Wyatt Hartley and his parents flew in from Vancouver were there. And talking most of the night, obviously talked of all their own football. I remember distinctly the first round of drinks came, and Susan stood up and raised her glass, and she said, "John, congratulations on an amazing home run today." The table went silent, and it wasn't until my wife started to burst out laughing that we all erupted in laughter. With that, she knows much more about football now, and she actually fed the entire Toronto Argonauts offensive line over a Grey Cup week in Ottawa. Thank you. When I think of family, I think of my time playing at Queens. I think of the guidance I received from outstanding coaches. The family connection continues. Maybe you don't know this, but Coach Shane is my second cousin by marriage. His support and guidance has been greatly appreciated. I joke often that he's the reason why he got the job, or I'm the reason why he got the job at Queens, but no one asked the offensive lineman who they wanted to coach for them. So. I'm grateful for the professional guidance I received from Coach Tracy, the intensity and dedication that I try to emulate and learn from Coach Mikulas, to Steve Jovetic and Bob Howes, who are major reasons why I came to Queens. I finally remember Steve Jovetic watching one of my basketball games in high school. I scored by 10 points and had my 5 fouls by the third quarter, so he didn't really get to see much of the game. To Rob Ball, who was actually my coach in high school, and I remember this, he told me quite succinctly after I got beat in a one-on-one, all he said was, "Never let that happen again." Great coaching advice. Thank you for the impact that you had on my life. Also, Tommy Hopkins, thank you. I can't think of a better person for first-year football players to meet as they come into the room. Thanks for all you do. Dave Ross, thanks for all your work. Thanks for resetting my pinky finger in a game against Laurier. Never been able to straighten it since, but I never missed a play. To the final part of my family, my teammates, or better yet, my brothers. Thank you for your blood, sweat, and tears in the field. Thank you for the lighter moments in the locker room, which can never be repeated here. I was blessed to have played with an amazing group of men and to develop bonds which run deep to this day. Tommy Dennison, it was a pleasure playing football with you, and we always had a special bond that only a center and his quarterback can have. James McClain, you were the most dominant receiver I've seen play. But what I could never understand is how someone who didn't look like they were running fast could actually outrun people. Matt Kirk, it was my honor to play defensive line with you. You're an amazing athlete. I remember you would always lap me in our cool down runs each Sunday. That one year we played defensive line, three of us are being inducted into the Hall of Fame right now, and we're all from Kingston, so I think it's pretty special. Finally, Corey Trudeau, you are missed but never forgotten. I've never met another person as strong on the field and as carrying off. I know your teammates will always be there for Louise and Jacqueline, and will happily tell your daughter stories of the amazing man your father was. I'm truly humbled by this induction, and I think if Pinball were in this room today and asked me, who are we? I'd quite simply reply, at Queens, we are family. Thank you very much.